scene, and I call my confidence in him. He's your bartender, Ken. I hope you've been tipping him. Yeah. Woo! Debut right now. Woo! Yeah. Woo!
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Squad Potty. And let's get something to say to you. I have a Squad Potty, and Squad Potty is a shit. So I grew up in the 80s, and there's a show called Double Dare. And one of the features was that you could double dare someone, or they can opt to do a physical challenge. So, yeah. I'd like for you to do a physical challenge. Woo! Stand up, and all right, put your hands like this. Spell the word image, and then say light bulb. We could do it together. And it's spelled I-M-G, I-M-A-G-E. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
I-M-A-G-E, light bulb.
I can tell this is a bright crowd. I like things up with a little light humor. So I grew up in a family restaurant like Maya, and as a result, I can't really do this. So I like to go out to eat. Anyone else here like to go out to eat? Hey. Here are a few stories of mine. The first one takes place in Canton, Michigan, at Rose's Italian Eatery. So a group of us went out to eat, and we're waiting for food. Someone stops by the table and says, "Naki." And we all look at each other and we're like, is she talking to us? And then she says again, "Naki." Oh, that's me. I ordered the special of the day, gnocchi, with mushrooms. And my friend, who was amply bosomed, said, "I thought she was talking about my boobs." So I guess don't Naki until you try it. The next one, my next story, is takes us to Detroit at the Fountain Bistro. Sounds it's not. It was a Detroit restaurant week. It was about maybe 12 of us going out to dinner. And we get our food, and the server, as being a good server, checks on us to see how we're doing after two bites and says, "How is everything?" And we're like, "Oh, it's great." And one person says, "Oh, this is delicious. Can you tell me about the verde sauce?" It's a green sauce. We all like avoid eye contact, we're like, "Oh, okay." So then he saw that we're waiting for more information. It's made with olive oil, some herbs, some cream. "Oh, okay, it's great, thanks." And then he goes back to the kitchen. We all burst out laughing once he goes in the kitchen. He's like, "Did he really say it's a green sauce? Isn't that what verde means?" So my last story, well, not really, my penultimate story, takes place in New York City, Chinatown. We went up to traditional dim sum where they push the cards and announce the food. Hukou! Feng Zhua! And me and my friend, there's about 8 of us sitting at a round table in the wintertime. And me and my friend are sitting with our backs to the aisle. And my friend is sitting down. She's leaning into the conversation because it's interesting. And we're getting ready to leave, so she reaches back to get her coat. And she reaches a little too far. And all of a sudden, she shrieks. I'm like, "What the hell's going on?" So, what happened was, as she did that, a lady was pushing a cart, and her hand went into the lady's butt crack. And she was like, "Oh my god, I'm so sorry." And the traumatized lady was like, "This is okay, this story's off." And I was turning bright red, and she's so embarrassed, but she can't stop laughing at the same time. So the next story I have is from the other side. It's a touching story of how me and Lindsay met.
Yay!
We used to work together at Canteen 1910 down the street.
R.I.P.
R.I.P. And running back at Clark. It was my second day of training, and she was my trainer.
Shocker.
So it was a slower time, and so I'm standing in the kitchen observing, as a good trainee should be doing.
I was probably on my phone.
Maybe. That might have been it. So in this kitchen, when they ask for a runner to run food, they say hands, because it's just faster. So I'm just standing there, and the chef turns to me and says, "Why are you just standing there?" And I just said with a straight face, "I'm here for the hand job." And Lindsay looks at me with this look like she's confused, like, "Are you being serious or funny?" Then she just burst out laughing. It's like, we're gonna get along just fine.
Yes.
So so I have two jokes for you.
Woo!
The first one is, what is Irish and stays out all night? Patio furniture. I was trying to miss Patio furniture. Before he left the party.
Namaste.
Stay here too, because we have more great comedians and some great drinks.
Yay!